Bev Brown has dedicated her life to saving a rather unusual type of orphan, flying foxes, also known as fruit bats.
Good boy.
They've taken over her whole house.
They are the most affectionate little creature, and they're just quite happy for you to rub their face, just talk to them, give them lots of affection.
Her mission is to help them survive the first 4 crucial months of life until they're weaned and able to be released. Without their mother to do it for them, Bev must give them regular feedings, groom them daily, and prevent their wings from drying out.
Soon we all grown up, grow so quickly.
Bev's bats all come from the same colony, a group of 30,000 that live in the heart of Melbourne city center. Unfortunately, living so close to human development means adults often fly into walls, fences, and electric cables, and their babies are orphaned. Bev's latest arrivals are Hannah and Bugsy. Hannah came into care a few weeks ago and is only 1 month old.
She was off a paralyzed mum. Mum had collided into a wall and broke her back, so we had to have mum put down. So hence we've got little Hannah, my little adopted girl.
All Bev's bats are tucked into specially designed blankets to simulate being wrapped up in their mother's wings. And as they're almost always attached to their mother's nipple, a dummy substitute provides some comfort. Hannah is only without hers when she's feeding.
She mourned her mum, I'd say for a good 2-3 days. She was quite down, a bit depressed. And then they start to realise that you're there to care for them, you're giving her a bottle, you're their mum. But she seems to be coming along beautifully now. Of course, I bonded to her instantly, but she's bonding to me now.
Bev's other new arrival, safely wrapped in his mother's wings, is Bugsy. They were found tangled up in fruit tree netting in a nearby orchard, the mother exhausted from trying to escape.
She was quite traumatized, had really, really sore lips from the netting. She also couldn't use her thumbs. Her thumbs were very sore. She didn't seem to have any milk.
When a bat mother suffers a trauma, her milk supply can temporarily diminish or dry up.
Come on, you have a way? Good girl.
And this is exactly what has happened to Bugsy's mother.
Good girl.
So Bev is supplementing Bugsy's feeds until his mother's milk has fully returned.
Okay. It's all right. It's okay. He's fine.
Naturally, the mother's protective of her baby.
He's coming back.
Sloths are not easy to take care of. Sloths are probably the most time-intensive orphan you could possibly ask for.
These sloths are nocturnal, need round-the-clock care, have a specialized diet, and are easily stressed,